gonna move. Usa, my. Well, I feel God. Usaba, ya de Dios saba, sataisa. Glory. My God. Ooh. He's in the room. I feel the presence of a mighty God. He's come to do some work. Hallelujah. He's come to deliver. Hallelujah. He's come to set free. He's come to heal. He's come. I love him. Jesus, my way over.
Thank you. provision for you. When the door was closed, he opened the door. We'll be right back.
That means I have been victorious. St. John 19, verse 30, he declares, it is finished. John 17, he goes on to tell the Father, I have completed the assignment that you've given me. And now I'm ready to be glorified because I've glorified you. Come on, I've dealt with it in my tribulation. See, we glory in tribulation. Tribulation worketh patience and patience experience and experience hope. And we're not going to be ashamed. because I know what he's already done for me. And I know that the best eyes haven't seen, nor ear heard, neither has it entered into the hearts of men. The good things. Ooh, okay, all right. The way has already been made. Don't you be like Israel, getting in trouble with God when the way was plain. They murmured and complained about what they had to go through to get what he promised. If he made you a promise, you got to wait until a manifestation of that word comes to life. You got to know that he's a God that cannot lie. Neither is it a man. Come on, man, that he's got to repent. If he said it, he's going to make it good. Wait on the Lord and be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. The way has already been made. Come on, clap your hands. Celebrate God. The enemy wants you to think that you ain't getting out of this, that your back is against the wall. But I need somebody here this morning who can testify. Clapping of your hands, stomping of your feet, to declare that when our back was against the wall and I didn't see no way, God made a way. He makes ways out of. Celebrate God, won't you? Celebrate him. Celebrate him. Because he made the way, we can enter into what is known as a fellowship, sweet communion. Communion is one of the sacred services, ceremonials that connects us with the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. It's a very important sacrament. Now, for those of you who are not here, those of you who are listening and observing over the airways, I invite you to certainly share in the communion service with us, because the Bible has said to us, as often as you do this, you do show the Lord's death until he comes. And we're doing this in remembrance of him. Appreciate the fact that you are here and thought it not proper to share in the fellowship of communion. The blood that he shed for us way back on Calvary has never lost its power. The blood still works. I said the blood still works. And we're coming now to share in the fellowship of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says that this was considered then the Last Supper, this last act of fellowship,
that he did before he transcended. And so we're coming now to share. Get your bread as your element. Get that wine, that juice, whatever you have. If you have nothing else, get water, get Kool-Aid, get punch, apple juice, cranberry juice, orange juice, whatever you have at home. If you're not prepared, I know some of y'all might have wine. I'm not going to bother you. Thank God for Jesus. Wine is the fruit of the vine. Okay. And don't dry up for me. It's okay. Thank God for Jesus. I keep trying to tell folk. We got a list of drinks that was in the Bible. Okay. Let me not do that. Let me go with communion. Okay, thank you, Jesus. All right. Stay with the word. He blessed it and gave it out. We're going to come now and share in our communion service. Praise the Lord. Bless you. Do you elders know that it's communion? Oh, I'm sorry. In a minute to that. Okay. I'm sorry. Come on. Where did she go? Bishop, can I put you to work this morning? Yes. I'm going to say this now because I'm working other Billups today, because today's her last Sunday with us officially as a member of Bethel Temple Church. The Lord has called her into other pastures to labor and work. Her birthright is here, and she'll always be a part of the family here. But today is her last Sunday officially as a member of the Bethel Temple Church. She has faithfully served the ministry over 37 years. She is a woman of good works. And whatever it is that I've assigned for her to do, she does it with a spirit of excellence. And she is faithfully committed to do whatever has been assigned to her hand. I'm appreciative of this woman of God who's labored here in this vineyard, first under Apostle Evans and then under yours truly. She's given both of us the same level of faithful commitment and service. We want to say we love you, sis. We appreciate you. All right. cup of the New Testament in my blood. Drink ye all of it. Wonderful worship experience here at the Bethel Temple Church of Christ. Place where God reveals his glory. We serve a mighty God who is faithful unto us. And we bless him. We invite you to come and join this, your family here at 3910 West Rogers Avenue. You can join us over the airways. Just call in, won't you? Someone will take your call and minister the word of God to you. If you need prayer, you can call this number, 410